2.4 times 2, because there's another side, and we're adding a little bit on the end to fold around. So. And then do the front as well. Round up to 1 point. So we need some material 1.5 inches high by 6 inches long, and then we're going to need a small piece for the hinge that's got to be 1.2 inches wide and maybe 1/4 inch tall for the hinge. So I'll write that down. Hinge is 1.2 inches wide, and then we'll just measure here just for fun. So the hinge is about 0.4 wide, 0.4 inches wide on this for the hinge, or tall, sorry. All right, so we're done measuring. This is an invaluable tool to have. So each one of the two squares is 1 inch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right at that line. And this isn't the knife I want to use. So I've been using this blade to scratch, so I want a fresh blade. So now we need it to be an inch and a half this way. So there's one, one and a half. So I'm gonna mark this right there. And there's little dots on my paper here that help guide me. Side. So there's the finished piece for the bellows. Then we need 1.2 wide. We'll double check that. .14. Lock that right there. And these lines make it easy to work with. And it needs to be 0.4 tall. So we'll lay this here. Alrighty, so cut that out. Okay, going to do the next bellows. So inch and a half tall. this. Then there's some crooked edge here I'm going to get rid of. That's close enough. So there's that for bellows number two. Hinge is 1.2. Wide. And then 0.4 tall. So now we got the right and the left material cut, so we're ready to glue it on and then do some more trimming. Put this thing up. So now I got to find the center line of this. So it's going to be 3. So 1, 2, 3. Just a light line. Don't make it really dark. Center line of that one. Center line of that. So we got that. So this is 1.2. half is right in the middle, and I'm going to mark underneath here. So I want the center line of the bellows top marked. I'll mark it up here too. So I got that marked, and I want the center line of this marked. And I'll just lay this on here and mark it there. It's crooked, but I'm gonna get ballpark and mark it there. And I'm gonna mark it inside just barely. This because it went with the grain instead of All right, so mark the center lines of both of these, and there's a reason for that. Right, I use contact cement for this. A lot of people don't recommend it, but with this type of paper it works great. So what I'm going to do is glue half of this to this side. Just like that. Lay that there. And then the center line of this goes to the center line of this, and put it in halfway. Look on the other side. Make sure it's square, and it sticks really good. And we're going to do needs to go that way just a hair, and it's already stuck, so it's pretty much on it. And I get this hammer, and I'm only using it for the size, the thickness, because I need to prop this up level. So we're going to glue all of this and then put it right here. This here and put it in the center line at the very edge. And we'll let it sit for a little bit so we can get a different angle. So you can see it's glued halfway across this, the top, and then all the way across the bottom. Okay, so this is dried about, I don't know, 5-10 minutes. So what we're gonna do is fold it. so that we sandwich it like so. Next, we're going to put the hinge on. So we're going to glue here. Here. And a little bit upon the bevel. Get all the strings away. And then bring it together. And then you want to leave a little bit of gap, so I wiggle it just a hair to give it a little gap. So we end up with something like this with the hinge on the back. I'm gonna let the hinge dry. Okay, next I'm gonna work on the sides. So what you want to do is glue the bottom half on the top piece and the whole bottom piece there. Put glue on the wood. And then what you want to do is open it up all the way and then fold this back and then shove it shove it on there. Just like that. Let the glue stick. And then what I'm going to do is start cutting the excess off. And I'm going to shove this stuff in. Just like that. Start my shaping. So right there, and I'll hold that, and I'm gonna just pop through here. I want some excess on the back, so I'm just going to come straight out. Once I start with it, I'm going to come straight out and make a point as close as I can get it. It's not going to be perfect. Top as well, only I'm going to do it halfway. So I'm just going to come up and draw a straight line along this. And then poke through out here and cut it. Try to get air gaps out of there. And then I'm gonna work some more here to tidy this up. And then I'm gonna bring this up into a triangle if I can without stabbing my hand. And then that excess is going to help with the hinge on the back once I get it glued. So here's the fold. You can see the special fold I did. And then there's some more trimming to make it look nice, which is right in here. So we're halfway done. This side is a little different. I got a pin here. I got to cut a hole for that pin. So what I'll do is just poke a hole right there. Poke another hole just a little bit on this side. This is kind of tedious to do. Okay. So then we're gonna glue that bottom half of the top and then the whole thing there. Just the bottom half. And then open her wide up and pull it tight. And flatten it out. Push it in. Just like so, and then you can hear it starting to work already, even though it's not dry. So I'm gonna trim. Gotta get all the crap off my hands. So we'll start here. Our way to the back. Then I'm going to do half down through here. Just keep coming out the back. Better. it look neat. And a little bit up off the front here. Tidy everything up and then just press everything down so there's no air gaps. And I'm gonna tidy this up a little bit. I'll scrape it, some of it off. And then tidy it up. Make sure it's all solid. Here's what we got. Get all your crud, excess crud, and we're going to glue the material onto the back. Tidy that up. Right. So there we pretty much have it. Glue the weight in, put the decorative cover, glue that back on, and she'll be ready to go. Yeah. All nice and neat.